Welcome back. You're still watching TV3 New Day. Now, research has indicated that for a number of countries that have recorded fatalities when it comes to COVID-19, majority of such people were amongst the aged and also people who had underlying health conditions, what we have come to know as comorbidity. Now, quite recently, during one of the press briefings, the Ghana Health Service indicated that hypertension and diabetes mellitus were two of the highest causes of COVID-19 deaths amongst the people who may have lost their lives due to the pandemic here in Ghana. And so the question here is, how do they come together? I mean, how do they worsen your situation? So if I already have hypertension and I get COVID-19 as well, how does it make my situation worse? Can I survive from it, or is it a clear death sentence once I have any of these comorbidities? And joining us today is Dr. Borte, and he'll be answering all those questions for us. And so good morning, Doc.
Good morning, Bella.
How are you doing?
I'm very well.
All right. First of all, break it down for us. When they say comorbidity, I know the Ghana Health Service has touched on it, but for the sake of people who may still not get a clear understanding of it, when you say comorbidity, what does it mean?
Well, when we use the word morbid, it's any form of illness or discomfort, disability. When they say mortal or mortality, it means the person is dead. Mm. But the talks of morbidity is people who are not feeling well. So okay. If we say you have comorbidities, it basically indicates that apart from what we are talking about, maybe somebody has hypertension, but also the person has other conditions that could affect the hypertension or has other conditions that hypertension could affect.
Okay.
So somebody can have can be pregnant, but then they have other comorbidities. For example, the person is pregnant, but the person is a sickle cell patient already. Or the person is pregnant and the person also has is diabetic, or the person is hypertensive or has thyroid disease. So you have pregnancy and then the other comorbidities that the person has, the other illnesses, other existing conditions the person has. Now, these conditions, for example, if somebody is pregnant and also diabetic or has thyroid or has sickle cell, the pregnancy can have an effect on the sickle cell condition the person has already.
Okay.
In the same way, the sickle cell can also have an effect on the pregnancy that the person has. So we call these things comorbidities or pre-existing conditions.
Okay.
In the
I'm listening. You were saying something.
Yeah, so basically that's how we is other existing illnesses or disease conditions that are existing in the person apart from the main thing we are talking about at the moment.
So each time I have a comorbidity, does it worsen my situation, whatever the sickness may be?
Yes, most likely comorbidities may worsen a situation. Hardly would you see any comorbidity, any other pre-existing health or disease condition making a new condition better. It only makes it worse. So if you have a certain condition and there are no other comorbidities, chances are that you would recover faster, you regain your health much faster or better than somebody who has other contending diseases to deal with.
Okay, so in this case where we're talking about COVID-19 and the fact that majority of the people who have died had some comorbidities, so hypertension, diabetes, and a few other things as well. Tell us how it works. So how do they come together? How does it worsen your situation if I already have hypertension and I catch COVID-19 as well?
Yes, it makes it worse for people who are having COVID-19 and also have cardiovascular diseases, heart problems, have hypertension, diabetes, kidney diseases. These things are likely to make their recovery slower and also would increase the chances of mortality or dying. For example, if you take something like heart diseases, cardiovascular diseases, hypertension inclusive. Remember when we say cardiovascular diseases, it's hypertension is one of it. You can have other heart muscle, heart valves, not beating regularly or beating well, rhythm problems. Somebody can have coronary artery, the artery that supplies the heart with its blood supply, it can be diseased. The heart muscles itself, the inner layer, endocardium, myocardium, pericardium, all these things is a group of cardiovascular diseases. If anybody has any of these things pre-existing, it makes their recovery from COVID-19 or any other thing more difficult. Mm. Now, this is a simple explanation. For example, if we take heart disease, you know that the heart is pumping blood throughout the body.
Yeah.
Anything that pumps, anytime there's any form of fluid, be it air or liquid, there's a pressure it moves with.
Yeah.
So air, the wind around us has its pressure. There's a wind pressure. If the wind pressure becomes excessive or the wind speed becomes excessive, we know it destroys things in the environment. When there's a windy, there's a storm, it's wind, but it can destroy things. In the same way, if pressure should go up in the circulatory system, it can destroy other end organs, other organs that may be on the periphery from the heart itself. Now, if somebody has a poor circulatory system already, and because of the fact that they have a cardiovascular disease, because hypertension itself is plaguing them. Now, the heart may be beating a bit too fast for somebody who may be hypertensive. The heart's rhythm of beating may be irregular, so we call it maybe arrhythmias, or irregular heartbeats may be present in the person already. Now, when somebody has COVID, we know that one of the symptoms of COVID is fever.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when there is fever in any person, naturally, the body's reaction is that the heartbeat also goes up even more. So for everybody who has a fever, the person seems to have much faster heartbeat. So you might say that I'm palpitating. So you have a pre-existing condition where the heart is beating irregularly or already beating fast, too fast than for your liking, and then you have a fever setting in as well. Now, this fever would then put more burden on the heart, which is already burdened.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this fever adds on to it, and then the heart becomes overburdened, trying to push blood around the body to try to move all these antibodies the body is producing to fight, circulate it around, come back and come and take some oxygen and go back. Now, this would make the person's heart condition worse. So a person with COVID-19, even though they may be having hypertension or they are dealing with their COVID, could end up eventually suffering from maybe a congestive heart failure, or they end up with irregular heart rhythms becoming worse.
Okay.
And that complicates it, and that is what is likely to kill them. Now, again, in the case of the COVID-19, you know that apart from the fever the person is having, COVID-19 gives a certain form of pneumonia, which is what we call atypical pneumonia. It is not like the regular pneumonia which you give antibiotics and it's going, because this is viral.
Mm.
Now, pneumonia alone, in one way or the other, reduces the lung capacity to take in the maximum amount of oxygen, what we call saturation, into the blood. So the lung spaces are already occupied with the infection. So the lung capacity, which probably would have your oxygen levels up to about 98 or 100%, because it's compromised as a result of the infection, is not able to take in that much of oxygen or air into the lung spaces in order to transmit into the blood to work the whole system up and give your body adequate oxygen supply. So when it happens in the case of COVID, where the lung has pneumonia and therefore is not getting adequate amount of oxygen to supply to the body, now the heart then has to come in again and overwork, that the little amount of oxygen that is giving to the blood from the lungs, let me go and deposit it to other parts of the brain as quickly as possible and come back and come and take more. So there is an overwork of the heart, and that is what can lead to heart attacks. Mm. So if a person has COVID and then the person dies from a heart attack, it's because there's an overwork. It's because there is reduced oxygen supply to the brain, reduced oxygen supply even to the heart muscles itself. And that can lead to a heart attack for somebody who has COVID. Even though it was a viral infection, it ends up affecting the heart because the heart is overburdened, it is overworked, and it will end up failing. Again, because it's a viral thing,
mm-hmm.
The virus in the blood, it can go a long way to even to affect the heart muscles itself. The infection can affect the heart muscles, the myocardium, the muscle of the heart. We call it myocarditis. So the myocardium itself can become infected and therefore compromise the effective beating or pumping action of the heart, which will eventually lead to other end organs suffering. Remember that the heart is the central pumping station. Yeah. So the kidney is dependent on the heart. The kidney takes about, for every heartbeat that goes, for every cardiac output that the heart gives out, the kidneys alone takes about 25% of that. And that is what the kidney needs to function. So in the case of COVID, where the heart function or the pumping ability, the cardiac output is reduced and all that, eventually the heart will also end up suffering. So this is basically how a person with a comorbidity like hypertension and cardiovascular diseases with COVID-19 is likely to die much faster than somebody who is not having a cardiovascular disease.
I see.
And it's the same thing, yeah.
Is this peculiar to only cardiovascular diseases? Because when you check the list that the Ghana Health Service put out, there are also other diseases like chronic liver disease, acute kidney, asthma, and diabetes mellitus. Does it work the same way for all these other underlying health conditions, or does it work differently?
Basically, it's the same. Basically, it's the same thing. On their own, individually and collectively, on their own, diabetes on its own also is a systemic disease. So diabetes, eventually, you can have somebody who is diabetic but not hypertensive, but the person can suffer from a stroke because the progress of the disease, the pathophysiology of the disease is that diabetes can end up affecting the kidneys, it can end up affecting the heart, it can end up affecting blood vessels, diabetes can end up leading to blindness because too much sugar is deposited within the capillaries of the eye, that's at the back of the eye, the retina, and eventually somebody can go blind. Diabetes can lead to a collection of plaques and what we call atherosclerosis.
Okay.
These things that would ensure that blood doesn't flow well to the needed organs, like the brain, the heart itself. So they alone, diabetes on its own, can even lead to somebody getting a stroke. Liver disease, likewise. Kidney disease, likewise. Mm. People with cancer, likewise. Even you realize that people who are obese, you realize that even if you look at the statistics in the United States, most of them, they said the blacks are dying more. Why? Mm-hmm. Because most of the blacks are, a greater percentage of the blacks are hypertensive and they are also obese. So people seem to have what we call the metabolic syndrome. So you have obesity, you have hypertension, there are some people who have four of these things together. Again, diabetes on its own is something that reduces your immune system. Because of the high levels of sugar, your immune system is compromised. Mm-hmm. You realize that diabetics usually would be getting boils more frequently, and therefore that should tell you that the immune system is not even fighting well. So diabetes alone is an immune system sort of antagonist. It doesn't help the immune system. So when COVID comes in, as much as your body is fighting, diabetes is also putting a dent on the power of your immune system to fight. So that makes it worse when somebody is diabetic and also has that. So now, if you look at the liver, the liver, if somebody has a liver problem, the liver is one of the most important organs in the body. It controls so many things. Its functions are all the chemical reactions in your body, they take place in the liver, sort of. Mm-hmm. So your clotting system, how your blood coagulates or how it flows, a lot of vitamin K's, clotting factors, and all these things. The liver is the main hub where these things take place. So if the liver is also challenged there, then it means that in COVID-19, you've read that COVID-19 has got something to do with what we call coagulation problems, where people's blood will be clotting or the coagulatory function of the blood is not apt, and therefore that also leads to end organ damages, that peripheral organs do not get good supply of oxygen and blood, and therefore they get damaged and then people die.
So if that's the case, is it a death sentence if I catch COVID-19 and I have an underlying health condition?
Not necessarily. Other people recover. It is everybody and their the way their system works. I know a friend who is diabetic in the US who had COVID, and the person has recovered.
How? So, I mean, was the treatment any different from anybody else who may have lost their lives?
But no, but you see, so somebody has diabetes, and the person's diabetes can be a well-controlled diabetes. Somebody's diabetes may be poorly controlled. It depends on how well-controlled you are. And no two people are the same, even when it comes to the two people having been declared that we are all hypertensive. Mm-hmm. But no two people are the same. Not everybody who has hypertension suffers from a stroke. Not everybody who has diabetes suffers from a stroke or gets peripheral sores or wounds or gets an amputation in the final analysis. So people are different. And in this era, everybody would want to make sure that I'm keeping my sugars in very normal levels or well-controlled levels so that at least you've done your part. And where, in that case, you are looking at maybe doing your moderate exercises, eating well, and all these things come into play.
Yeah.
Again, the fact that you don't even have diabetes or hypertension or any other comorbidities does not mean that, as for you, if you get COVID, you can never die.
Okay.
Whichever way it is, we all need to be careful. Those who have comorbidities would even need to be more conscious of what is happening and know how to take care of themselves even more.
Okay.
Another thing is that for those who are hypertensive, there's this thing about COVID. The way COVID works, the virus, it actually binds to something we call some receptors. This may be a bit of physiology and a bit difficult, but I'll try. They bind to some receptors in our system, some enzymes. We call them angiotensin converting enzymes.
Okay.
Now, these enzymes are found in the... Oh, we shouldn't go there.
Oh, no. I mean, break it down for us just briefly. I just have one more question after that,
all
so
right.
We can go. Yeah.
So, for those who are hypertensive, one of the ways is that we all have something called angiotensin converting enzymes. And one of the ways of controlling BP for some people is the angiotensin, this enzyme aids the conversion of something we call angiotensin 1 to angiotensin 2, which would, under normal circumstances, cause somebody's blood pressure to go up. So the work of this medication that we take, which is the angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibitors, is to inhibit the enzyme from working. So it will inhibit the enzyme. So that it will break, it will stand in the middle. So the enzyme, the conversion doesn't take place to angiotensin 2.
All right.
Other types of medications are angiotensin receptor blockers. So
in the case
where the conversion has taken place from angiotensin 1 to angiotensin 2, this drug ensures that the angiotensin does not bind to its receptor in order to cause hypertension.
Okay.
So the receptor blockers, if we use as medication, ends up going to block the receptor, final receptor. But then in this case, it ends up increasing the amount of angiotensin enzyme in the system because they are not getting anywhere to bind to. So what we have noticed in the case of COVID is that for those hypertensives who are on these ARBs or ACE inhibitors, we realize that their angiotensin may go up. Sorry, their ACE enzymes will go up.
Okay.
And the virus will get more of enzyme to bind onto. So for them, their doctors will manage them and then maybe take them off those medications that, because Corona came and the physiology has realized that it loves to get angiotensin enzymes to bind to.
Okay.
And so the more of it that we have in the system, that can also make the situation worse for a hypertensive. So anybody who is hypertensive and gets COVID, or maybe even in this time, your doctor may even say that, let's look at these medications you are and then maybe switch to another thing.
Okay. All right. Well, this is all time will allow. We'll continue this conversation, hopefully, on COVID-19 360. I would have wanted to ask you some more, but unfortunately, I'm being counted down. So thank you so much, Dr. Bose, for speaking to us on comorbidity, and all the best today and the rest of the week.